On the left side of the screen, you can see a Raspberry Pi 5 connected to a 10.1-inch HDMI display. This acts as a visualization terminal. On the right side, there's a clear glass cup filled with hot water. ESP32-S3 thermal camera module powered by a compact 3.7-volt ripple battery is moved around the hot glass cup to observe how the heat signature changes from different angles. As the camera moves, the thermal viewer running on the Raspberry Pi dynamically reflects the outline of the cup. You can clearly see the heat distribution with the hot region centered around the cup. The system also displays the maximum and minimum detected temperatures in real time, updating with every frame. Now let's zoom in on the actual hardware used in this project. Here, I showcased the MI0802 thermal camera module integrated with an ESP32-S3 board. It's a lightweight and portable setup, can be powered by a rechargeable lipo battery. On the right side of the screen, I have added a detailed specification table of the MI0802 sensor. This module captures long wave infrared light and outputs radiometric data, meaning each pixel represents an actual temperature reading, not just a visual intensity. It has a resolution of 80 by 62 pixels, totaling 4960 temperature sensing elements. The frame rate can go up to around 29 FPS, and the sensor supports a wide temperature range up to and beyond 400 Celsius depending on the lens model. It consumes very little power, just around 40 milliwatts, making it ideal for battery-powered applications. Let's dive into how the Raspberry Pi and ESP32 thermal camera communicate over the network. Both the Raspberry Pi 5 and the ESP32-S3 thermal camera are connected to the same local Wi-Fi network. In this setup, the ESP32 acts as a TCP server and the Raspberry Pi acts as a TCP client. The Node.js script running on the Raspberry Pi initiates a TCP connection to predefined IP address, the address assigned to the ESP32 thermal camera. As soon as this TCP connection is successfully established, the ESP32 begins streaming frame data in real time. These frames represent the thermal image captured by the MI0802 sensor. On the software side, the Node.js server running on the Raspberry Pi processes this incoming data and serves it to web-based thermal viewer. Simply accessing localhost on the Pi brings up the interface. This viewer dynamically renders each incoming frame and overlays the current maximum and minimum temperatures detected in the scene. This Node.js-based viewer is for simple testing, but it includes everything you need to test and explore the MI0802 thermal camera in real time. From frame streaming to temperature analysis, color themes, flip mode, and full screen, it's all built in. So if you're working on your own thermal camera application or just want to experiment with the MI0802 module, this setup gives you a solid foundation. I have never tried a thermal camera in my personal projects before, but I plan on trying out some applications with it. I will come back when I have some cool projects done. Alright, that's all I have now. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.